The position of women in Islam. Islam has honored women and freed them from servitude and subordination to men. It has also liberated them from being a cheap commodity with no respect or honor whatsoever. Examples of forms of respect Islam shows to women include the following. Islam grants them the right to inheritance, allocating them equitable shares with men, which sometimes differ under certain circumstances depending on their relationship with others and the financial obligations they have to discharge. While men support the family as a matter of religious obligation, women are not obliged to spend a penny. It establishes total equity between men and women in numerous matters, including financial transactions. As the Prophet said, women are the twin halves of men. Sunan Abu Dawud, 236. It grants them the right to choose their husbands and places a large amount of the responsibility of bringing up children upon her. As the Prophet said, a woman is a guardian of her husband's home and is responsible for it. Sahih al-Bukhari, 853, Sahih Muslim, 1829. It grants them the right to keep their maiden names. In Islam, a woman does not change her surname to that of her husband upon marriage, as is common in many parts of the world. Rather, she retains her maiden name, and thus her independent personality. It makes the husband's duty to spend on those women entitled to his support, such as his wife, mother, and daughters, without attempting in the least to remind them of his favors. It stresses the importance of helping weak women who are in need of support, even if they are not one's relatives, and urges its followers to engage in such a noble act, regarding it one of the meritorious deeds in the sight of Allah. The Prophet said, "The person who looks after a widow or a poor person is like a warrior who fights for Allah's cause, or like one who performs prayers all night without slackness and fasts continuously and never breaks his fast." Sahih al-Bukhari, 5661, Sahih Muslim, 2982. Women that Islam enjoins Muslims to look after. The mother. Abu Huraira narrated that a man once asked the Prophet, "To whom should I show kindness most?" "Your mother," he replied. The man said, "Then who?" The Prophet again said, "Your mother." The man further asked, "Then who?" The Prophet replied, "Your mother." The man asked again, "Then who?" The Prophet said, "Then your father." Sahih al-Bukhari, 5626. Sahih Muslim, 2548. The daughter. Uqbah bin Amr narrated that he heard Allah's Messenger say, "Whoever has three daughters and he remains patient with them, provides for them, and clothes them from his money, they will be a shield for him from hellfire on the day of resurrection." Sunan ibn Majah, 3669. The wife. Aisha narrated that Allah's Messenger said, "The best among you are those who are best to their wives, and I am the best amongst you to my wives." Sunan at-Tirmidhi, 3895. Islam considers the relationship between husband and wife to be complementary, each of which remedies the deficiency of each other in building the Muslim society.